A U.S. jury rejects the death penalty for Nicholas Cruz, the gunman who killed 17 people at his former high school in Parkland, Florida in 2018. Instead, the jury decided that Cruz be sentenced to life in prison without the possibility of parole.
We, the jury, unanimously find that the aggravating factors are sufficient to warrant a possible sentence of death. Yes. One or more individual jurors find that one or more mitigating circumstances was established by the greater weight of the evidence. Yes. We, the jury, unanimously find that the aggravating factors that were proven beyond a reasonable doubt outweigh the mitigating circumstances established. No.
Relatives of the victim shook their heads in disbelief as the verdict was read. Cruz pleaded guilty last year to the Valentine's Day murders. A lawyer for Cruz, however, urged jurors to show mercy to a young man who she described as a brain-damaged, mentally ill, broken person. A two-week joint naval exercise of Filipino and American troops set to conclude today, Friday, in the Central Luzon region. Over 3,000 troops took part in live fire exercises Thursday, simulating an assault on a terrorist lair. Bianca Dava gives us the highlights.
At the Colonel Ernesto Ravina Air Base in Capas, Tarlac, personnel of the Philippine Marine Corps and U.S. Marine Corps fire shot after shot. Their target, a terrorist's lair located in the valley. Marines from both sides work together in attacking the target. But it's all part of the Marines' Combined Arms Live Fire Exercise, or CALFEX.
The scenarios that was conducted was the capture of enemy camps and destruction of enemy forces. The CALFEX is very important since, as we all know, it's a live fire exercise. So we must practice how we execute this live fire to ensure that not only the Philippine Marine Corps forces but also the U.S. Marine Corps forces can conduct these activities safely.
For the Philippines, the exercise meant testing some of its equipment, such as light armored vehicles and 155mm howitzers with their U.S. counterparts. The U.S. Marines also fired at the target using their High Mobility Artillery Rocket System, or HIMARS.
8 rounds of HIMARS. That was followed by approximately 35 minutes of suppression. USMC fired 155s that were then followed on by the Philippine Marine Corps firing their 155s.
When the coast was clear, the Filipino and American Marines moved in to try and breach the enemy line through assault by continuous firing. Attack aircraft also flew in as reinforcements. They provided close air support to the troops on the ground. Major General Charlton Guerlain said the Philippine Marines has already done what was simulated in the exercise in the actual battles against the Abu Sayyaf group and other terrorist groups.
What you witness is always being used in the battlefield, especially during the campaigns in the southern Philippines and also against the communist terrorist groups and also the Abu Sayyaf group. And we have been successful in using all this capability to defeat these threats. The new equipment that we have, we just arrived, that's why we're happy to be able to use it. And maybe in future campaigns, we can likewise utilize this new capability to defeat the threats confronting the country.
The CALFEX is one of the last drills of the Philippine and U.S. Marines before the two-week Kamandag bilateral exercise comes to an end on Friday. The joint drills finally occurred after a two-year hiatus because of the COVID-19 pandemic. It also comes at a time of rising tensions between the United States and China. For U.S. officials, the two groups have achieved their goal to successfully exchange tactics and expertise in various areas and to learn to work together as allies.
There's two important things that are happening here. There were particular tactical skill sets that we were working on, the live fire integration with our Philippine Marine partners on the ground was one of them. But more importantly, what you see is the combined strength of two like-minded nations working together toward common cause. It's a very uncertain world that we live in, and I will tell you that there's nowhere better to be standing than arm in arm with our Philippine brothers and showing common purpose in our actions for all to see. The Philippine people have been magnificently represented by their superb armed forces throughout this entire exercise, and it's a real privilege to be here working with them.
To further strengthen its combat and operational capabilities, the Philippine Marine Corps has acquired new assets, including shore-based anti-ship missiles and anti-air missiles, through the Armed Forces Modernization Program. The new assets are expected to arrive next year. Bianca Dava, ABS-CBN News, Capas Tarlac.